time has finally come. I'm here today to announce that I'm going to retire from the game of ice hockey. One thing's for sure, I won't be able to second guess myself. I really tried, and I tried, and I tried. And I'm really sure about my decision this time. It was not an easy decision. And believe me, the process I went through was even tougher. I've been very fortunate. I've been surrounded by great teammates, trainers, coaches, throughout my entire career. It is perfect for me to announce my retirement here in Denver as a member of the Colorado Avalanche. And finally, I'd like to thank the great fans of Denver and around the world for their tremendous support and the way you embraced me. They will embrace me from the beginning. Played hockey all my life, but I came to this decision that I played my last and final game. Thank you.
He holds himself to such a high standard. It's amazing and shocking and disappointing, certainly, for a Colorado fan base that was at home tonight waiting for their team with Forsberg in the mix to play Calgary. But you just knew when you heard him speak, he wasn't at a level where he wanted to be putting himself in front of those fans that have cheered for him at such a different level all those years ago. There are often moments in sports, specifically hockey, the sport that we love and cover, that can stop you in your tracks and make you think, what was I missing all along the way here? And we were certainly, well, I'll speak on my behalf saying that I was very disappointed to hear the news out of Denver today that Peter Forsberg was retiring, but I think I was more stunned along with that because we just spoke to him on the fly after his first game on Friday night. So what was your feeling with Peter Forsberg's announcement today?
I was really stunned by it, and let me just preface it this way. I think initially I give Peter Forsberg the world of credit to go through all of the surgeries that he did to just have another chance at playing in the National Hockey League. That speaks to his character, that speaks to his commitment and his toughness, mental toughness, physical, emotional, you name it. And he worked extremely hard to get back. He put himself in a position to get back. But Duffer, you talked about us about being surprised. I'm as surprised as you are because I've spoken to some members in the Avalanche organization. They're raving about how good he is. They're raving about how fit he is. They were so excited about it. And then this news comes. Also, I've spoken to some other players in the league, and the interesting thing is a couple of the players that I've spoken to were excited to get a chance to play against him because he was their favorite player growing up.
Right.
Guys literally, and I can't name, but they literally have his posters, and a couple guys said that they wouldn't have minded getting his stick from the trainer if and or when they got a chance to play against the Avs. So that just goes to show you how well-respected he was and, yeah, how this really caught us by surprise.
I get that people are going to make the natural comparison to Brett Favre because it's on again, off again. You know what? I have to
not
say
even.
This. No, it's not. No, okay,
yeah,
you explain.
You.
No, explain to me why, because I'm pretty sure it's the same reasoning that I have. Why is it not anywhere close to the same situation?
Well, first of all, from Peter Forsberg wants to play, and he wants to play for all the right reasons. Again, he's put himself through almost double digits of surgeries just to
for
be
sure.
able to play with absolutely no sideshow, with no negative press, only in the hopes of wanting to play again.
Mm-hmm.
That's my thing with him.
And it's not to say that Brett Favre didn't battle injuries and issues
sure.
along the way, but Brett Favre never missed a game.
Exactly.
This is the point. You're
exactly.
talking about a guy who, in
he's
his press
his
conference,
fill.
Talked about 8 years
yes.
of battling the same problem and trying to get through it to get to this point.
Absolutely.
So, completely different situations, yet at the end of the day, probably both Hall of Famers.
Yes.
I think we know Favre's going in the NFL. Would you suspect that Peter is as close to an automatic, or do you think it's going to be a long process before Peter gets to the Hall?
I'll say this. I'm not sure about the committee, but from my experience in playing against him, Peter Forsberg is a Hall of Fame player. I played with Hall of Fame players, and clearly I played against them. Peter Forsberg is one of them that I believe belongs in that category. The way that he played the game, the uniqueness to his game, you hear how many players now, present players and past, say he was their favorite player. That should tell you, if a guy of his stature was your favorite player, I mean, he's unique. 2 Stanley Cup championships, 2 gold medal championships. I mean, MVP of the National Hockey League. This guy just did so many things so well. The interesting thing for me, Duffer, is the way that he played.
Yes.
Honestly, I can't say that there was another player that I played with or against that played his style. There isn't.
Unique is a funny word, isn't it? I mean, if you're going through real estate listings, I'm not sure you want to see. You know, it's an interesting choice people list it. But now, what makes Peter unique? I mean, why is it so hard to find a comparable to Peter Forsberg?
Folks, here's what I'll share with you. When you go into a practice situation and a coach says, guys, today we're going to do one-on-one battle drills. Some guys will look up, some guys will look away, some guys will shake their head. Peter Forsberg starts frothing at the mouth. That's exactly the way he plays the game. Hard, he loves the one-on-one confrontations, he loves the battle. Aside from the skill set and being able to make plays off the rush, Duffer, this guy engaged in the battle, would love to go down. His best work was from the dots down off the cycle. The interesting thing for me is, playing against him, I'm looking at him down in this corner. He's got one defenseman that goes over there. Then the second low forward goes over there. Then the third, the second forward, which would be the third guy, comes in to help. So he's playing one on three and then still is able to either bull his way past them and or set the table for a pass that comes right out into the slot and he puts it on a golden tees for the players. Very, very tough way to play.
It's not a well-kept statistic in hockey, time of possession, but Peter probably held on to the puck more than most players in the course of his career, right?
Puck on a string, Velcro, and the ability just to spin off defenders. Yeah. And, I mean, guys, like, you have to understand, he was able to beat three-man coverage. Yeah. Not very many guys could do that.
Well, we certainly appreciate the effort, and disappointing to be sure that the folks in Denver don't get to see him tonight for one last time, but they know what they saw over the course of what should be a Hall of Fame career.